What is going on, everybody, and welcome to today's video with me, your friendly neighbor pirate Wardwix. In today's video, we're going to be testing out both Ice Barrage and Ice Burst at Dust Devils. For this, you will need to have ancient magics unlocked, of course, plus also access to Dust Devils, so you'll need to have 65 Slayer. You'll also need 70 magic to actually use Ice Burst, and or if you're wanting to use the Ice Barrage, 94 magic. Obviously the Ice Burst will get less experience, so probably less money. I'm going to be testing this out to see if we actually do make money back. I've heard rumors that you do make your money back. You actually make profit off of this, plus you can like do Burst and Barrage in here, so we're going to test it out and see what happens. So I'll be using the same gear for both methods, both the Ice Burst and the Ice Barrage. So what we're going to have here is we're going to have the Slayer Helm, so you have to have a Slayer Helm or a mask, like a dust mask. So we're going to have the Slayer Helm Ion, as it is the better one of the two. Stardom and Cape, just from Mage Arena 1, because I haven't done Mage Arena 2. Occult Necklace, Ancient Blessing, Ancient Staff, Adam's Top, and Bottom. Now, you can use Prayer Enhancing Gear here, but because we're trying to go here for more of the damage, or we're trying to go for more experience here, we'll hit better, we'll hit like higher amounts with the Adam's Top and Bottom, or at least that's from what I've been able to gather, so that is why we're using it. Book of Darkness, Barrow's Gloves, Mystic Boots, and a ring, and a Berserker Ring, or sorry, a Seer's Ring, no eye on it. I've taken just like very easy to get gear. This is maybe, maybe 5 mil total gear worth here. It's very, very easy, like, the gear to get. That is why I've used this. You can upgrade this gear a lot. You can get better, like, bodies here. You can get, like, a Malediction Ward. A lot of different stuff. Staff of the Dead, for example. A lot of different stuff that you can upgrade this gear. I'm just going to go with very, like, easy to acquire gear that most players can, like, get if they want to. In the inventory, we're going to have a Avis Assembler. Just take whatever Avis device you have. It doesn't really matter that much. And then we're going to have some Bronze Darts. These are just to tag the Dust Devils so we can actually barrage them. We're also going to have a Bone Crusher. This is very, very important because this makes it so that it buries the bones that they drop, but gets your prayer back, which means that this is basically, you should never run out of prayer here. We are going to bring a Prayer Potion just in case, but normally you don't. A Herb Sack. Now, if you have a gem sack, also bring that. I don't actually have that, so I'm going to just, like, I'm just going to take the extra talisman as in place of that, and I'll just write down all the gems that I would have gotten and add them in at the end. I just don't have a gem pouch. A rune pouch also will help out a lot, as you can put your runes inside of there. Obviously, we're going to be starting off with Ice Burst, so you'll need runes. You'll need Chaos Runes, Death Runes, and Water Runes, and that is it. So let's find a world and get into this. And in case you do not know how to get to Dust Devils, just to the left of this bank here on Zia, there is a trap door here that you can, like a trap little thing here, that we can enter. You will have to actually open this. You'll actually have to go into the Catacomb of Karend through, like, by the altar here and run down, and then, like, run down past the ghosts over here, down here, and come up here once to actually open it. But after that point in time, you can use it as many times as you want, and then you just have to run past the sun crabs here, and then the Dust Devils are right here. So as you can see, it is very close to a bank when we do need to bank. And also, I completely forgot, we'll also be taking a Black Dragonhide body, because you have to wear that to actually save your darts. It's not like it's anything much, but it's a little something. If you were to use all these darts, it would be like 50k lost. So that might influence this down to a loss. So yeah, we're also going to be bringing the Black Dragonhide body just so we can save the darts here. So let's start the hour here with Ice Burst and see what happens. And just to show you how this is done, so you're going to equip your darts, your Black Dead body, and your Avis, whatever one you have, put your prayer melee up and just tag each one like so. Just run around the room. On rapid is fastest way to do this. Just hit each one once, then go to some or another spot over here, over there, over there, over there. Well, you have two, like, we have like a corner just like this, and then just run between them, and then they'll pile up, like stack up on one another, just like so. Then you can just switch back to your mage gear, put on your spell, and just let it do its thing. That's how you actually corral them all into the same spots so that your spells do work. Okay, so here we are. We just completed the first hour here. This will be the hour that we did Ice Burst in. So we got ourselves 106k Mage XP, 58k HP XP, 750 Prayer XP, and 8,500 Range XP. this is actually a lot better than what I thought I was going to get. I was expecting somewhere more around 70 to 80k mage experience, so 106k, not that bad whatsoever. Plus, you have to remember I was banking most of the items here as I was trying to make, I was just trying to like even on the money. So if you're just saying after the items, you can get more experience. Plus, I did around 30 minutes in have a guy try to crash me for a good 5 minutes. So that also wasted a bit of experience. So honestly, you could probably expect to get more around maybe 110k. So yeah, it's not bad. 110k experience per hour. In magic, not bad. Let's check into the loot here. So we're going to do this in two different price checks. So this is the first inventory. This is going to be the bulk of it here. 693. So I'll just quickly get the other inventory here. So here's the second inventory here. This is with the sapphire and the emeralds that I said I had to go buy. Hence, so I'm at the GE here because I didn't have the gem bag. So yeah, but it is what it is. So 60k GP from the second inventory here. Okay, so all in all, in the hour here, we made 75,426 GP, but this is not taking into account the runes and other stuff that we used, so now we're going to take that into account. Okay, so here is all the supplies that we used. So we used about 3 prayer potions, 732 roughly, bronze start, this number maybe up. It should be correct, I believe. It's within 50 or so, up or down. Nothing too, then like hardly 1 or 2k probably difference there. And then just the runes for the spells cast. So only 450k. That does mean that we make a profit. Let us see how much of a profit we actually did make there. So in this hour of bursting, getting 100k mage experience, about 8k range experience, about 50k or something like that, HP experience, we made 302,000 like KGP in the hour. That's wow. This does not take into account the bone like charges, the bone crusher charges. We used about 343 of them, so we got about 343 kills in the hour, but still, like that's getting 100k plus mage experience an hour, bursting, making 302k per hour. That is insane. So let's move on and test out Ice Barrage and see if that'll do any better. It will obviously cost more to use the barrage spell, but maybe we can get more kills because of it, or we can just get more experience. Let's see. And for our second hour here, where we're going to be using the Ice Barrage, we're going to be taking the exact same gear, everything exact same, except for the fact instead of having the Chaos Runes in our Rune Pouch, we're going to be having the Blood Runes in here, hence why it's going to cost more, but hopefully we're going to get more experience, and henceforth more GP. So let's test it out and see what happens here. So here we are, we just completed the hour of using Ice Barrage. So we got ourselves 96k HP XP, 8k range XP, 127k mage XP, and 880 prayer XP. You can, if you see here that the like XP per hours are a little bit different than what I actually got here, this is because there are bank times and it took me a little time to get over the GE. But in the hour here, I got 127k prayer mage XP, so that is not bad whatsoever. But let's see how the money is looking. Okay, and here is the first price check. This is like the bulk of everything, so let's check this. 1.1 mil. That is significantly better than last hour. I don't know if it's just the fact that I got some like maybe better drops this hour, not certain on that. But I do know from the prior experience that I did kill more Dust Devils, so let's get the rest of the price check here done. And then here is the miserable last little price check here. 37.5k, still not that bad. So all in all here we made just over 1.2 mil, so let's just call it 1.2 mil in the hour. So that is not bad, but remember we were barraging, so it did cost a lot. So let us see how much cost us and factor that in. Okay, and I do want to add here that I just checked out the, just started like trying to get all the stuff ready for the end part here, doing the bronze stars now. I think I might have messed up on the bursting one with the bronze stars, because I think I had like 600 or so, and I only used 102 in this one, which actually, now thinking of it, that doesn't actually make sense that I would have used that many darts. So it's actually less darts used by a significant portion there. Still nothing too much. These darts are fairly cheap, but maybe take like, maybe we make an extra 6k on the amount from the original one. Just want to add that in here now, and then we'll go back to the whole like ice barrage thing now. Okay, and then here are the supplies that we used again. The only three prayer potions. Again, as I said earlier about the whole bronze darts thing, this one should be significantly more accurate. And then the runes that we used. So let's check this. 816k, bit more than last time, but we still made a profit. So let's see how much that profit actually is. So our profit here came to 383k. GP, so that is, again, not bad, and for 120k mage experience, and you're making 383k GP per hour, that is not bad at all. You do, however, have to deal with, like, your biggest issue, all in all, will just be dealing with the people, when it comes to that. There's not, like, there's only really one spot per world, so people are very, very competitive about it. But if you can find like a deader time, or you can have like a solid like 2-3 hours where you can do it, like in the early morning or late evening, it's not that bad whatsoever. Making GP plus being able to burst or barrage, that is not bad whatsoever. And also, I used 400 charges from my Bone Crusher for this trip. And I would just like to thank you all for watching the video. Hopefully this these methods here have helped you train your mage up, get to that 99 faster, and a little bit cheaper, actually making some money. So as I said, hopefully it helps you. Thanks for watching. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and peace out.